Hi students, welcome to the video lecture 2 of module 3 topic transportation problem. In lecture 1 the topics covered were formulation of transportation problem, types of transportation problem and examples of balanced and unbalanced transportation problem, where we also saw how the unbalanced transportation problem can be converted into a balanced transportation problem. In today's lecture, we'll discuss about basic feasible solution, methods of finding basic feasible solution, northwest corner rule, and least cost entry method. Basic feasible solution, also referred as BFS in short, a feasible solution is called as BFS if total number of allocations is equal to m plus n minus 1. That is number of supply plus number of demand minus 1, and this is also called as non-degenerate basic feasible solution. If the total allocations is less than m plus n minus 1, then it is called as degenerate basic feasible solution. There is also called as optimal solution. A feasible solution is called as optimal solution if it minimizes the total transportation cost. The methods of finding basic feasible solution are northwest corner rule, that is NWCR method, matrix minima method, also called as least cost entry method, and Ogle's approximation method. Now let us see how we find basic feasible solution using northwest corner rule method. The procedure of NWCR: select the upper left corner cell, that is nothing but the northwest corner of the transportation matrix, and allocate minimum of A1 and B1, that is minimum of supply and demand. Step 2. Subtract this value from supply and demand of respective row and column. If the supply is 0, then cross, that is strike, that particular row and move down to the next cell and update demand value, that is B1 minus A1. If the demand is 0, then we have to cross or strike that column and move right to the next cell and update supply value, that is A1 minus B1. See, after each allocation, you need to find the new northwest corner for the allocation. If supply and demand both are 0, then cross, that is strike, both row and column and move diagonally to the next cell. Step 3 is to repeat these steps until all supply and demand values are 0. Now let us solve a problem on NWCR method of a balanced transportation problem. The problem definition is: find solution using northwest corner method for the following table. This S1, S2, S3 is nothing but the supply. D1, D2, D3, D4 is nothing but demand. So here supply is given for S1 and demand is given here. So if you identify summation of supply, we are getting 34, and summation of demand is coming 34. Since supply is equal to demand, the given transportation problem is a balanced transportation problem. So now we need to identify the northwest corner cell. So now this is the northwest corner cell where we need to make the allocation. So if you see, we identify the northwest corner cell as 1, 1, that is minimum of 7, 5, that is 7, 5, minimum of supply and demand has to be checked, and we identify that demand is less here, minimum, so we make the allocation here, that is 5 is been allocated there. So since 5 is allocated there, it is equal to demand there, it is equal to demand there, so we need to strike this particular column, we need to strike this particular column, and at the same time this 5 has to be reduced from 7, that is 7 minus 5, remaining has to be written here, that is 2. After this step, you need to find the next northwest corner cell. So the next northwest corner cell is identified as this cell where we need to make the allocation. And again, here supply is 2 and demand is 8. This has to be compared here, minimum of 2, 8. So 2 is the minimum, so 2 has to be allocated at that particular cell. So 2 has allocated. Here if you see, 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. It has been satisfied here. It reaches the supply here. So no more supply can be done in this particular row. So this particular row has to be striked off. So it has been striked. At the same time, this 2 has to be reduced from demand. 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. So next northwest corner cell has to be identified. So it has been identified as this cell. Now in this particular row, you need to check the supply is 9 and demand is 6. That is minimum of 9, 6. We identified 6 is minimum. So 6 has to be allocated here. 6 has to be allocated here. So now since the demand is satisfied here, it is equal to demand. This particular column will be striked off. This particular column will be striked off. At the same time, this 6 has to be reduced from 9. That is 9 minus 6 will come. 3 is the remaining. So in this way, we need to solve the problem, dear friends. So the next northwest corner cell is identified as this. So 3, 7 has to be compared. 3 is minimum. So 3 has to be allocated here. 3 has to be allocated here. And this particular row has to be striked off. So 7 minus 3 will become 4. 7 minus 3 will become 4. So next northwest corner cell is this. So comparison will be 4 and 18. 4 is minimum here. That has to be allocated there. So this particular column will be striked off. And next 20 is the next northwest corner cell. So 18, 4 is compared. So 18, 14 is compared. 14 is minimum here. 14 will be allocated there. 14 will be allocated there. 14, 14. Okay. So now, since all the supply and demand are zero, here the total number of allocated cells is equal to 6. Is equal to m plus n minus 1, that is 3 plus 4 minus 1 is equal to 6. Hence the solution is non-degenerate basic feasible solution. The total cost is identified as this 19 is nothing but the matrix cost given, and this is the allocation of the whatever we have done in that particular cell. If you solve this, you will get 1015. Okay. Now let us solve the next problem on NWCR method, that is unbalanced problem. Here summation of supply is coming 23, summation of demand is coming 35. Since supply is not equal to demand and supply is less than demand, the given transportation problem is unbalanced transportation problem. Hence we need to add a dummy row with supply 12, which has been done here, So the similar procedure is been followed for the allocation of the cells. So this is the northwest corner cell. Comparison of 6 and 14 is made. 6 is minimum. So it has been allocated and it has been striked off. 14 minus 6 is 8. So the next northwest corner cell is this. 10 and 8 is compared. 8 is minimum. That has been allocated there. That particular row is striked off. 10 minus 8 is 2. It has been left over here. Next northwest corner cell is this. So 2 and 6 is compared. 2 is minimum. That has been allocated there and it has been striked off, and 2 is reduced from 6. You will be left with 4. Next northwest corner cell is 2. 15 and 4 is compared. 4 is allocated as it is minimum, and that particular row is striked off. So 15 minus 4 is 11. It has been left here. So next northwest corner cell is this. 11 and 3 is compared, 3 is minimum, which will be allocated here. So that particular row is striked off, and 11 minus 3, 8 will be left here. Next, northwest corner is this. 8 and 12 will be compared. So 8 is minimum, that will be allocated here. And here 8 will be striked off, and 8 minus 12 minus 8, 4 will be left. Here 4 is left, that will be allocated there. Okay. Now, since all the supply and demand are 0, the total number of allocated cells here is 7 and is equal to m plus n minus 1, that is 4 plus 4 minus 1 is equal to 7. As the solution is non-degenerate basic feasible solution, and the total cost is found using the same method what we have done in the previous problem, that is whatever the cost we add in that particular cell into number of units allocated in that particular cell has been multiplied. So the after solving you get minimum total transportation cost as 112. Now we'll see matrix minima, that is least cost entry method. The procedure for matrix minima or least cost entry method are, we need to determine the smallest cost in the cost matrix of the transportation table. Let it be Cij. Allocate Xij, that is minimum of Ai and Bj, that is minimum of supply and demand in that particular cell. Step 2 is, if Xij is Ai, is equal to Ai, cross off the ith row of the transportation table and decrease Bj by Ai and go to step 3. So it is the same case, dear friends. We after allocation, you need to reduce that particular allocated units from the supply or demand, and we need to strike off if it satisfies supply or demand. Okay. Step 3 is, repeat steps 1 and 2 for the resulting reduced transportation table until all the requirements are satisfied. Here there is a note for you. Whenever the minimum cost is not unique, make an arbitrary choice among the minima. Now let us solve the problem. So this is the problem here. So here this is nothing but the source and this is nothing but the destination. We can call it as factory and this as warehouses. So here supply is equal to 34 and demand is also equal to 34, hence it is a balanced transportation problem. So here if you see, least cost cell is this. 8 is having a least cost, so you need to compare 8 and 18. 8 and 18. So here 8 has to be allocated here as it is minimum, as it is minimum, and that particular row has to be striked off, and that particular row has to be striked off. At the same time, you need to subtract it from 18, that is 18 minus 8 is 10, 18 minus 8 is 10, that has been kept here. So the next minimum least cost cell has to be identified, which is coming as 10 here. So now 14 and 7 has to be compared. 7 is coming minimum, that particular 7 will be allocated here. That particular 7 will be allocated here. So this particular row will be striked off, and at the same time from 14 we need to reduce 7, 7 is left here. So the next minimum is 40. So there is a tie here, there is a tie here 20 is the next least cost cell. Here the comparison is 10 comma 7. Since 7 is minimum, that will be allocated there, 7 will be allocated there, and that particular column will be striked off, and 10 minus 7 will be 3. So the next least cost cell is this. Comparison is 5 comma 3, so 3 will be allocated here, and that particular row will be striked off, and 3 minus 5 will be 2 it has been kept here. The next lowest is here. So 7 and 9 is compared. 7 is minimum. That's why it has been allocated here. And it has been reduced at the same time to 2 here. So here the last allocation will be made here because this is the only one left now. The 2 is allocated here. Now, since all the supply and demand are 0, here the total number of allocated cell is equal to 6 is equal to m plus n minus 1, that is 3 plus 4 minus 1 is equal to 6. Hence, the solution is non-degenerate basic feasible solution. The procedure for calculating the total cost is same and it comes around 814. So, I request you to solve some more problems. We'll meet in the next class with Ogle's approximation method. Thank you.